Hey everybody, it's Christy the Bird Nerd. I am going to be showing you how to make homemade nectar for your hummingbirds and the feeder that I'm using, which is this one. I got it from Wild Birds Unlimited and it's so cool. If you like this video, please make sure to like and subscribe so that you can get updates on whenever I post more videos. These are the hummingbird feeders that I have. This one is from Wild Birds Unlimited. I really like this one a lot. It has a little ant moat in it. And this one I got for my birthday from a friend, and I love it. I switch out between both of these. I don't hang both of them up just because that's kind of too much, and I really only get like one or two hummingbirds, but hopefully this year I'll get more. For this one, at the Wild Birds Unlimited, the top just comes off and you put the nectar in there, and it has like a little measuring thing on the side. And underneath, it has the holes where the hummingbirds drink from. And I got this from Wild Birds Unlimited. It's a nectar guard tip, and that way nothing can get in. Like the bees or wasps can get in there, like flies, and they can contaminate the nectar. It has helped a lot, but recently one of these little prongs broke on that one, so I only have three on there right now, and I've had a few flies get in there and contaminate, so I have to kind of clean and refill the feeder a little bit more often than I used to. And then this one's cool. It just screws off the top and it's glass. And it comes apart like this. And this, you can't really put the nectar guards on, but I still love it. It's really pretty. I got this cute little hummingbird handheld feeder recently, and I have yet to use it. It's just like a little dot you put in the nectar, and you can hold it out and feed the hummingbirds from your hand, and it tells you how to do it. It takes a lot of patience, and you have to be consistent with it. I like to follow these instructions that I got with my nectar dot feeder, and it tells you how to make your own nectar. So you would do like 1 cup of plain white sugar and 4 cups of boiling water. So I have done that before, but I prefer to do 1/2 cup of sugar and then 2 cups of water. So I just like half that recipe, and I just put it in here, my little pot with the sugar, and then you stir it around. So as always, I will put links in the description about what I'm using and the products that I got and where I got them. I'm also going to include a link below to the Hummingbird Central Google Maps, and it shows you like where all the hummingbirds are located and if they're in your area and what kind they are. And it's pretty cool. It showed all the recent sightings, so check that out. Post a link below to the Audubon website. There's an awesome little article there about how to care for hummingbirds and take care of the feeders and the nectar. And it's pretty much just like a frequently asked questions thing. That's a pretty helpful guide for anyone new trying to learn about how to care for hummingbirds. I know my mom just recently bought a hummingbird feeder in December last year. So I know she's gonna get ready to gear that up for the hummingbirds. And just for any newbies out there, that would be a really great resource to check out. That you're taking care of the hummingbirds the best way that they need it, and you're not, you know, putting in these harmful dyes in the nectar, because they really don't need that at all, especially if you use a feeder that has like red or yellow, because they're attracted to that color. So nectar is just so cheap and easy to make. There's like really no excuse why you would just go to the store and buy a jug of like harmful hummingbird food when you could just make it at home. And pretty much everyone has regular old plain white sugar, and all you need is sugar and water, and you know, have to have the right ratio. So yeah, bottom line is pretty much don't be lazy and be responsible for when you're feeding any types of birds, but especially hummingbirds, because they require a little bit more attention to the nectar to make sure that it's not getting expired. And if you don't think that you can be responsible enough to maintain the nectar, then I highly suggest just putting out some good outdoor colorful flowers that you can get at the garden center, at Walmart or Home Depot, Lowe's. They're pretty cheap, especially for the springtime. And also you could do that along with your feeders too. That would be great. And I know they would love that. And I know you're really gonna love getting your hummingbirds, cause I do every time. They're so cool and tiny, and they have these cute little chirping sounds. Oh my gosh, I just love them. They're so awesome. But yeah, let me know if this video gave you any helpful ideas or tips, and please leave a comment and like. I really appreciate your support. Thank you. Another thing I would like to note before I go, I did just create a Instagram account just for my wild birds, because I love to take pictures of the wild birds with my DSLR camera, and I get some really good shots. So I will go ahead and put a little snippet of my Instagram name so you can follow me and give me some love.